One in five Americans will develop skin cancer by the age of 70. It is the most common cancer in the United States, yet in most cases is preventable.
Today is Melanoma Monday, a day to raise awareness about skin cancer and a reminder to take extra steps in reducing your risk.
Joining us live online right now is Dr. Sandra Oswald, a board-certified dermatologist and the chief of dermatology at UT Health San Antonio's MD Anderson Cancer Center. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Thanks for joining us. Well, first of all, tell us about skin cancer. What exactly is it and who is at risk?
Wonderful question. You know, there are three main types of skin cancer. There's basal cell carcinoma, which is the most common, squamous cell carcinoma, and then, of course, melanoma, which is the deadliest form of skin cancer. And anybody can get skin cancer. However, those at increased risk includes those with light or fair skin complexion, red hair, skin that is easy to burn or sunburns easily, and those with a family history of skin cancer. It could be melanoma or any type of skin cancer. Even those with multiple atypical moles in melanoma in the family history can have increased risk. And then those, of course, who are chronically immunocompromised, like those who have had transplant, are increased risk. But we do know that exposure to UV rays is the most important preventable cause of skin cancer. And watch out for those indoor tanning beds, because that certainly increases your risk for all types of skin cancer.
Dr. Oswald, what are some warning signs for us to remember?
So what I tell people is that they should be looking at their skin. And if there is a skin lesion, let's say that is new or changing, perhaps one that isn't healing or is bleeding spontaneously, you really should get that checked out. And then for melanoma particularly, we have a tool called the ABCDEs. A is for asymmetry. If one side of the mole looks different from the other side, or B for border regularity. So if the borders look very jagged or irregular, color, say they have multiple shades of brown, or you could even have white, red, or blue colors in a mole, and that's not good. So we want to make sure that you look at all of those things. Another thing is E, evolving. If you happen to see that you have a mole that is changing, we recommend you check your moles every month. You'll be the best one to detect any change. And if a mole is changing significantly, don't wait and get checked out.
And how should we protect ourselves or reduce the risk?
Well, fortunately, there's many ways to do that, many measures. One, of course, is to stay out of the sun, particularly during the hours of 10 to 4. And if you're outside, try to stay in the shade. Wear a big wide-brimmed hat to cover your face and your ears. And you might want to wear some beautiful big sunglasses, even lip balms with have sunscreen in it. And then use that sunscreen, which should be both UVA and UVB. We call that broad spectrum, at least 15 to 30. And apply that every couple of hours. Okay, and so we also want to tell you that you should put sunscreen on every day. You may think you're safe inside by a window or driving around in your car, but actually UV can go through the window, so you can get UV every day. So make sure you use your sunscreen, make sure you apply it well, liberally, and make sure you reapply every couple hours, because no matter what your SPF factor is, you're gonna lose some while you're walking around or sweating or doing your activity.
It's so interesting. When in my first TV job, I did a skin, I did a sunscreen test, and anything less than 30, it was like I was wearing nothing at all. You're not surprised by that, are you?
Not at all, because there's many reasons why your sunscreen will work. And one of them is just how much you put on. You know, you really have to put on a good amount to get that protection they're asking you for. And so I'm not surprised. Good job on doing it.
Sure. Doctor, help us dispel some myths about skin cancer.
Okay. Well, one of the myths is that people with dark skin types don't get skin cancer. And here in San Antonio, we have people with many different colors of skin. And we want to tell you that everybody can get skin cancer. Even though those with light skin, I've told you, are increased risk, anyone can. And there's particularly a type of skin melanoma that people with darker skin types can get. And that one occurs on their hands and feet and on their nails. And because people with skin and color don't think they can get skin cancer because they don't burn easily, they will delay in coming in. And so unfortunately, people with skin of color with these particular types of melanoma can come in late or when their melanoma is already advanced. So we'd like to just make sure and know that everyone know that anyone can get skin cancer and everyone should get checked. Another myth is that only older people can get skin cancer. And actually the truth is that yes, older people get skin cancer and melanoma because of the cumulative effects, but melanoma is the most common cause of death in young women ages 25 to 29. And unfortunately, they believe that may be because of indoor tanning bed use. And so we say no to tanning bed use. Please do not do indoor tanning because it increases your risk not only of melanoma, but all types of skin cancer.
And if go ahead.
Also, another myth is that you don't need to wear sunscreen in the winter on a cloudy day. And you may notice that you don't feel the heat of the sun's rays on you in the winter as much as you do right now in the summertime. However, those harmful UV rays are present year-round, and so you do need protection year-round.
I was going to ask, and if you have skin cancer, what types of treatment are available?
That's great. If you catch skin cancer early, and particularly melanoma early, you have the ability to have great prognosis. For instance, melanoma caught early stages, you have a 99% five-year survival rate with us just removing it by surgery. But not to worry, actually, at Mays Cancer Center and other places, now with advanced melanoma, we have more promising therapies for you. So what I do want to say that even if your melanoma isn't early where we can easily just remove it, even if it is advanced or spread to other locations, we now have chemotherapy that is specific to melanoma mutations. We also have a large family of treatments that are called checkpoint inhibitors that help your immune system, enhance your immune system to fight melanoma. So we want you to not be afraid to come in. We don't want you to delay. We want you to come in because we have promising therapies for you.
All right. Well, we're headed into the spring and summer months, so I'm so glad we covered all this. Dr. Sandra Oswald, Chief of Dermatology at UT Health San Antonio MD Anderson Cancer Center. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. Have fun and stay safe.
Thank you very much. Have a good rest of the week.
Keep up to date with all of San Antonio's top news, weather, and so much more by clicking the like and subscribe buttons below. And once again, thanks for watching KSAT.